Welcome everybody to another new arcade corner. My apologies for the long absence of there being any more episodes. I know it's been a few months since I've last done one, let's just say a point. In a nutshell, real life has gotten in the way a lot, and I haven't been able to do as much video material as of late. But I was really wanting to try to get this episode done out of the way. I've had the footage up for a while, and you know, I figured I might as well try to get this put together. But enough rambling. Today's game is Dyna Gear, and there's not much of a story to it other than you play as a intergalactic, I guess, warrior, officer or something, and you're chasing down a wanted intergalactic criminal known as Gustav. I think the hero's name here is Roger. So you're chasing him throughout the galaxy, and then after a long, hard fight, I believe both ships take a drastic hit, and both of you end up crash landing on this prehistoric planet. So now, with the help of this creature known as Wolf, this big buff wolf creature you see here before you, which is also player two in this fast-paced platforming game. Mission is to track down Gustav and bring him to justice, pretty much. So that's basically it. How this game plays out, like I said, it's a real fast-paced type of platformer. You're basically running around shooting at anything, any kind of creatures, monsters, that's foe alike, with different weapons that you may find, whether it be with swords, arrows, knives, or even spike ball and chains, depending on what weapon might suit you best, given the situation. You have a little bit of a power of a life meter. You can only take with so many hits. I think you get about at least 4 or 5 hits per life. And of course, the more of the same weapon you pick up, the better and stronger and even faster that the weapon will be. And then sometimes in between levels, you might come across a fellow dinosaur companion that may be willing to help you. Such as whether it be a pterodactyl, a T-Rex, or whichever, or even if it's another wolf-like companion, like so. This was made by Sammy Corporation back in the day when they were, well, they haven't really made a lot of games, I don't think, from what I did a quick search on. This came out of the back about, 94, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. This is another one of the, I guess you could say, another one of those rare titles that not many people may know of its existence about. It's not that common. So consider it a bit more of another one of those rare gem types, if you ever happen to come across one as such. As far as the game itself goes, it's pretty fun. It's a pretty nice experience when me and a partner of mine that actually managed to get around to playing this. Player two is actually used to be my previous next door neighbor before he was kind of forced to move out. Sadly, would have wanted to do some more gaming stuff with him, if ever given the opportunity. Who knows? So you get a chance. You get a choice between either playing as Roger or the Wolfman. And I guess he would decided to play as an alternate color of Roger here this time. Let's see. What else is there to say about this game? There's so many so many dino coins to collect to try to gain a certain amount of points. I believe if you get enough, you get at least a one up or two. I forget what the needed amount is. But other than that, it is as you see it, going around from different parts throughout the prehistoric planet. I don't even think they have a name for it. And actually, there were some reptilian natives. That was a weird looking one. Is that like a watermelon rabbit sized helmet or something? I don't know. That's kind of strange. We got some stegosauruses, T-Rex, all kinds of dinosaurs here. And I suppose at some points it's a little bit of a quarter muncher. Well, there's a downed ship. That's where Gustav is. Oh, there's Gustav. You die. Says when did Gustav all of a sudden have control over a dinosaur? That don't make no sense. It's like, why didn't he? Unless he has some kind of mind controlling device. I don't know. That's probably the only way I could see that working. Because that dude should have been dead. But I'm arguing game logic here. So. See, this looks like a. That looks more like a bit of a baby T-Rex. I always thought T-Rexes were bigger than that. It was worth a lot of money. Go, go, go! And that was Area 2 cleared. Did it say bonus? Bonus? Well, like I said bonus, but I'm pretty sure it meant to say bonus. Okay, so now we're at a dino village. The village is in a tunnel? A cramped tunnel. Okay. Yeah, I like this auto shot thing. I think you just hold it down and it'll just be throwing axes everywhere all day long, or whatever other weapons you might happen to come across. So, yeah, as you can see, it's a pretty fun little game. This must be the thwomps of this game. These are more lethal! I mean, you don't even get a chance to try to dodge them, no matter what you do. That's like almost instant death right there. Are those exploding mushrooms? Those are exploding mushrooms. Ow. Yeah, that kind of sucks. Okay, I think I decided to take control of Wolf on this one. For a change. I like the sprites, the way they got them set up. It's like they try to run as fast as, almost as fast as like Sonic or something. Oh, we got a little baby, we got a T-Rex or a companion on our side, okay. This dude can breathe fire. Oh, that's pretty sweet. Oh, wait a minute. No, okay. I think he just bites. I think he just eats it. Yeah, he just bites. I thought he could breathe fire. It looked like it did. Now we got some more of the evil reptilian natives to pretty much mow through. I mean, that's all you're really doing here is just mowing through everything as much as you can. Checkpoint. Yeah, they should have, I kind of wish they would have put this game like on other multiple platforms, like whether it be, Xbox Live Arcade or some other PlayStation, something in the collection classics or something. Maybe if there was a Sammy game arcade collection style classics or something, maybe they could have put something like that on there. That'd have been good. See, that was another mini boss fight we just finished. Oh, all those coins I missed out on. Ah, oh, god dang it. I was hoping he would jump a little bit higher. Ooh! What kind of dinosaur is this guy? That's some nasty looking claws. That's like a big ass raptor or something. I don't know. I don't exactly give the names of all these different kinds of dinosaurs you fight throughout this game. I just call them as the way I see it. So yeah, off topic real quick before getting back to this. Like I said, I know it's been a while since I've done any more arcade stuff. I am hoping to try to get back to doing some more episodes for you guys. Sorry for the long gap, and delay in videos. I've been brainstorming some other ideas of other games I might want to try doing, as far as other classics, like maybe something from, some of the other Nintendo games that might have been made its way to the arcade, or even Super Nintendo, but who knows. Of course, I'll try to stick it with those specific kinds of games, but I always say again, if there's any arcade classics that you want to see that I have not covered yet, I'm always taking requests, so feel free to make a suggestion. But anyways, back to the game here. So now we're going through some kind of hidden temple? It's like a labyrinth. It's like a freaking labyrinth, but it's filled with all kinds of mechanical traps, like glow torches and cannons and stuff. This is probably one of the worst types of levels here, since you can't actually, you know, just be all willy-nilly with the running and gunning this time. You've actually got to really pace yourself here and try to figure out where you're going. I want to say there's like multiple directions you can go, but I think there's really only one. And those guys just came out of freaking nowhere. Oh, this guy. Oh, this dude's pretty nasty. I remember fighting this guy now. Can be hard to avoid sometimes, like when you're trying to wait for him to uncurl himself and he's not rolling into you. That has gotta hurt. Okay, I was wondering who my partner was. Oh man. Oh, there we go. Get some meat. Oh, and then there's these traps here. Oh god, yeah. I always seem to have, like, whoa, little porcupines? Those look like little saw blades. Those are lethal. Ow. Not as lethal as those, though. I think there's a couple of instances where you might have to use them as actual platforms to advance. And if you can hear the noise from outside, I apologize in advance. It's kind of unavoidable, but I don't know. Sounds like some kind of huge truck moving around or something. I don't know. Beware of falling rocks. Oh yeah, thanks. I think rocks are the least of our worries here. Calm down? What are you telling me to calm down for? Tell me to calm down. I want to get through this place. This place ain't no joke. Now they're dropping boulders on us. Oh, is that what you meant when watch for falling rocks? Right. Okay. Well, with rocks as big as those, there's usually not much you can do about it. God. Well, we're just running and gunning at this point. Oh. And then there's this guy. This thing of a ball. Well, he's not really that big of a deal. Yeah, we've had him down in like not even 10 seconds. So, as far as my understanding, I think Sammy mostly did like a bunch of Japanese fighting games and stuff at the time. For, I think, Sega use mostly that. Wait, is this a bonus? This is a bonus area, isn't it? Oh god, we messed that up. We destroyed the only, we done used up the only, you know, spring there was at the bottom. We couldn't get over top. Oh, that sucks. We could have gotten something real good for that. Oh well. Okay, so now we're going to some other, some other ruins here. Oh god, I can't believe something small like that killed him. You know, I don't remember there being giant mutated flowers like this back in prehistoric ages. Then there's giant, what is that, beetles? Giant flying beetles? I just love to crap on you all day long. Yeah, I think it's at this point that our lives just keep dwindling and dwindling, and we're just throwing in, like, continue after continue. I've lost count already of how many credits we've gone through on this. So, again, I ask if anybody wants to try to keep count and give us a final count at the end of this, leave a comment. Feel free. Okay, that kind of hurts. Was that a goat? I can't tell, because everything's going so fast. It's kind of hard to see. Okay, look like an orc with an axe. And then there's these weird-looking dragons, I guess? Or lizard? Flying lizards? Long necks? Things are almost impossible to dodge. It's like you have to take a hit when you're trying to go through it. It's crazy. There's some more mini pterodactyls. Whatever those are. Whoa! Where that came from? Did the volcano just erupt? Fire is like dropping everywhere. What the crap? It's raining fire! Ow. I think that had been like, what, my fourth checkpoint on this level? Must be at a boss now. Little critters can all easily be some of the most annoying ever. Pretty sure we got a mama one coming soon. Kill enough the babies, you're gonna get the mama. That might be the mama. Yep, there's the mama. That's it? That's not much of a boss. Let's see, that was area 5 cleared. Okay. Now we're going from ruin to grasslands to deserts. Oh, the deserts. Filled with spike balls floating about. Well, if we know our spike balls from different games, we know how lethal they can be. Looks like he wants to say, let me help you. Sure. By all means. There floats boat. We're gonna call him Roly Poly. Roly Poly Dino. Okay, I'm not even gonna bother. I'm not gonna try to pronounce what that thing is. Okay. It could be this a creature like that. Okay. At least that doesn't look like some weird looking worm that could be seen as something else. You know, looking at this level now with these kinds of enemies, it almost reminds me of, what was that game? Super Return of the Jedi? I think? That one Star Wars platforming game? Where you play as Luke? That one hard platformer, which I remember when I always struggled trying to get past that level, because you start out in the desert and you see all those weird looking, bug creatures coming out from the sand, especially that one. Oh, we got a Triceratops up in it. Oh! Yeah. Yeah, those are lethal. extend like that. It's nice to help a have a that's a big dino right there. You're only seeing its head. Ow. Oh, you're gonna kill a dino friend, aren't you? Nope! Oh! Already done! Well, see ya! Where will you be ya? That was a pretty nice hefty bonus right there. See how we're doing for scores. I think I'm got a bit of a higher score right now, yeah. Oh, so now we go from desert to sky. Sky Palace. So I think we got this in one more level, and then that'll probably do it for this game here. Okay, I don't know what that thing is, but I'm just going to walk right... Well, I tried to just jump right over it, but that didn't seem to work. I think those little green bushes, for some reason, are unkillable. Don't fall down. Yeah, thanks. I think that's pretty obvious that one shouldn't fall down. The thing is, there really? I don't really recall if there was any bottomless pits in this game at all. Or if it just made it look like there was. Because I think no matter how far down you go, there was always something at the bottom, and then you can always climb back up. I could be wrong. It's been a while since I've went through this, because like I said, when I did this previously, this was like about a few months back when I recorded this. Okay, there's those bridges right there. I think this is what they meant when they said don't fall down them. Those bombs? Those are trap bombs! I almost forgot about those. That's messed up. Take him away. Take him away? Well, as in put us in or just take the dino friend with you. Okay. Well, by the way, we got a pterodactyl. That one breathes fire! That one breathes fire. That guy's awesome. That guy's pretty sick. Ooh, is that some kind of weird tiger creature? Holy crap. This dude was loaded. And that's the end of that level. And he flew away. That was kind of short-lived. Okay, we're down to the last level already. So here we are at the castle. There's actually ooh, and we're fighting dual pterodactyl creatures. Actually, if memory serves, this is a bit more of a... Yeah, this is another one of those gauntlet boss type of deals. Oh, the dude is helping you now! Oh, that's sick. That is awesome. Oh my god. Hey, how many of those T-Rexes are there? Punch and kick them. Get them. Get them, dude. What are you just standing there for? You wanted to help us? Help us out. Mow their asses down. Aww. Hit that fool! Are those like snake-like soldiers with dual swords? That's weird. Okay, so there's another. Well, okay, so much for that boss. Maybe it wasn't a boss. Alright, so we finally got inside the castle gate. I don't know what those things are, but it's kind of weird bubble thing. Oh, evil triceratop. That just got kicked in the groin. Oh, another one of these guys. Oh, no. And there's spike balls above us. We can't jump over them. Unless we destroy those spike balls. But they take so much to kill. Oh, my God. How does that not hurt that dude? Oh, buff dude got killed. No. Oh, that sucks. I kind of wanted to have him when we finally get the blue stuff. Ooh. That was... That had a lot of money. Holy... Whoa. Those mermen? Oh, merman fish-like creatures? Holy crap. What is this, Castlevania all over again? You're ripping off Konami here, Sammy. Stone-headed guy again. I think this is the second part of the gauntlet. Alright. What do we got next? Oh, this guy. This guy's back again. I hate when they don't give us enough room because of the stupid spike ball. This is what makes it even worse. Oh, there goes him. Okay, when you see this many treasures, you know the boss is coming up. There he is. There's good stuff. And he turned into a freaking giant electric fish? Oh, no. Now he's a dinosaur. Now he's a weird-looking dinosaur. That's bouncing around. And then he morphed into a pterodactyl. Ow. That's certainly taking a lot of credits there. He's causing the whole thing to come, the whole castle to collapse. Come on.
I can't believe I was beaten.
I thought he had one more form. For some reason I kept thinking he did. Okay, well, that's it, peeps. This was, Dyna Gear. I know this was, like I said, not much story to it, but pretty much, mindless fun, fast action platforming. Hope you enjoyed the game, and, look forward to, more episodes to come sometime in the near future. Oh, they got their ship repaired with what little repair there was. So Roger was able to return to his planet safely because Wolf's comrades had repaired the damaged starship with whatever primitive materials there were. I don't know how that works, but okay. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you look forward to some more to come in the future. And again, as I say, if you got any suggestions on what games you'd like to see for the Arcade Corner, please, by all means, list in the comments below. I want to thank my buddy JD for being two-player on this with me, if he ever gets a chance to see this. And I, Arclad, am signing out for this episode. So take care, and as always, keep on gaming. See you next time.